So the theorem we're trying to prove is that if x and y are real numbers, and x and y are both greater than 0, then the ratio of x to y plus the ratio of y to x is greater than or equal to 2. So there's nothing in particular about this expression right now, this inequality, that's jumping out at me as clearly true. So what I'm going to do is just plug in some numbers and see if I can get some intuition about why it's always true. So I'm going to start with x equals 5 and y equals 2. And if I plug those two values in for x and y, I get 5 over 2 plus 2 over 5 on the left-hand side. Now, the thing that I notice right away is that one of the terms, 5 over 2, is 2.5, which by itself is already at least 2. So I didn't even need the second term. Just the first term was sufficient to get a value that was at least 2. So this might not always be the case. Let me try values of x and y that are a little closer together. So I'm going to try x equals 5 and y equals 4. So again, 5 over 4 plus 4 over 5 on the left-hand side. And if I compute the value of these two fractions, I get 1.25 and 0.8. Now, the sum of these two values is, in fact, at least 2. In fact, it's 2.05, which is greater than or equal to 2. But neither term by itself is at least 2, so I really need both terms. Now, it's still not clear to me why it's always going to be the case that no matter which two real numbers I choose, these two ratios are going to sum to a value that's at least 2. So what I'm going to do is go back to the original inequality that I'm trying to prove back here. And the thing that I'm having trouble reasoning about is the ratios. They seem kind of hard to get a handle on. So I'm going to see if I can use a little algebra to develop an equivalent inequality that doesn't have the fractions in it. And I can do that by multiplying both sides by y and multiplying by x, and that will get rid of the two denominators. And I know I can do this because I know that x and y are both positive. So I can multiply both sides times x, and I can multiply both sides times y, and the direction of the inequality is going to stay the same. So let me just do that. I'm going to multiply the left-hand side by x times y, and the right-hand side also by x times y. And let's see what happens. So when I multiply xy times x over y, the two y's cancel, and I get x squared. When I multiply xy times y over x, this time the x's cancel, and I get y squared. And the quantity I have on the left-hand side is 2xy. So now this is starting to look like an expression that's more familiar to me. It's looking like a quadratic expression. So what I'm going to do is take this 2xy over to the left side to consolidate things a little bit. And now I get an expression that I really do recognize. I've seen this expression before, and I know that I can factor it. So let me do that, and I'm going to express it as x minus y squared. So now I see why this inequality is true. X and y are two real numbers, so their difference is always going to be a real number. And it doesn't matter whether the number is negative or zero or positive. When you take a real number and you square it, you always get a quantity that's greater than or equal to zero. So now the final proof is going to use what I know. It's going to be a direct proof. So I'm going to assume the fact that x and y are real numbers and positive, and I'm going to argue that this inequality holds, just as I just did. And now I'm going to reverse the steps that I took to get here, and eventually end up at the inequality that I'm trying to prove. The proof is going to be a direct proof because I'm going assuming the hypothesis that x and y are positive real numbers, and I'm going to prove this inequality. Although the steps go in the reverse order of the way that I did my scratch work. So in the scratch work, we started with what we were trying to prove, and we sort of worked backwards to get to this x minus y squared, but the proof, being a direct proof, is going to go forward and end up at the inequality that we're trying to prove.